We were doing, I think I've told you that this is not a context free, this is Chomsky. Okay, so I haven't uploaded the PPT. I will upload the PPT today. And just let me see. So in the previous lecture, I have discussed about because we are doing the elimination of null production as well as annihilation of unit production. I've already told you the reason why we tend to do this, and also I have added some extra thing, that elimination of useless symbols. Okay, there are three things we have done, but mostly in Chomsky normal form, we will use only two things. Okay, so keep in mind anything that is given in this format S tends to either it will be two terminals, two non-terminals, or it can be a single terminal. Okay, so single terminal can also include epsilon. So epsilon is also a terminal. So it can be a terminal, a single terminal, or two non-terminals. Okay, so the advantage of using this Chomsky normal form, it serves as a pre-processing step to different algorithms. Okay, so if there is any algorithm given in the solution in the syllabus, I will discuss about that part also. But mostly Chomsky normal form and Gribach normal form, there are two normal forms. Chomsky normal form, that is also popularly known as CNF, and there is another form called a Gribach normal form, that is also called a GNF. Okay, so I'll come to that. There are two normal forms, though they will again follow the same thing, that you have to get rid of the epsilon production as well as unit production. Okay, so that is why I've done a little bit. I've taken this step individually, and we will approach this step now. If you see the algorithm, it is very, very easy to understand. There is nothing to it, and the algorithm is just saying that this step is the most important one. If S is present at the right hand side, suppose this is the production that is given to you, and this B is like AS. Okay, so the S is present at the right hand side. You just have to start it. This the first step. You just have to include this production, that is your index production. Okay, so you can write it as S tends S dash tends to S or S0 tends to S. So that is one and the same thing. Okay, so this is your first step. If it is included, then you have to, the second step is reduce your null productions. Third step is delete your unit production, and the fourth step is a very easy one, because after reducing it, it will be very easy to understand. Now in the fourth and fifth, that you just have to do a little bit of a substitution. So only the little bit of substitution that in the fourth and fifth. Okay, so now I'll discuss a little bit of an example to you. It is very easy to do, just it's a little bit of a lengthy thing. Okay, it is very easy to do, but just it's a very lengthy thing. Okay, so just I take a question and I give you a solution to this question. So this is the first question. Oh, the most of the time will be taken by eliminating your epsilon production as well as your unit productions. Okay, so only that step will take a lot of time. Okay, so A tends to B, and then there is a S, and then B tends to a B, and then there is epsilon. Okay, so if you're seeing, there are many things here. First of all, there are unit production also in this expression, and there are also epsilon production. Okay, so it can also happen that when you are eliminating epsilon production, it can also be included in other. It can also result in other inclusion of new epsilon production. So again, you have to deal with accordingly. So the first step, if S is coming at the right hand side, if you're seeing S is coming at the right hand side. So you have to include the production, that is your starting production, S naught tends to S. So there is particularly no use of that, but if you studied about parsing in compiler, so the stack is not left empty. Okay, so always there is an index symbol that is there to identify that we reach at the end. So that is why it is always included if it is present in the right hand side. So there is nothing, no specific reason to it. If you do not include it, I don't think it will affect. But the algorithm says this, so you have to go like this. Okay, so now S naught tends to S and write all the production as it is. So this is your step one. You just check if S is at the right hand side, include this starting production and write all the things as it is. So it will be written as it is, A tends to, and then B and then S and then B tends to, single B and then epsilon, okay? So the second step is to get rid of null productions, okay? So just let me see, that second step was null productions, I think, yeah. So how to get rid of null productions, you know about this, that is why I've extensively discussed about null productions. So eliminate null productions. Okay, so the only null production that is present in this particular question is your B tends to epsilon. So this one, okay? So I don't want this null production. So just don't do anything. Write all the things as it is. Just don't include this production, okay? So S naught tends to S, S tends to A, S, A, A, B, and then A tends to B, and then S, and then B, okay? So don't include this. So we have to eliminate this production. By eliminating it, so start with this symbol. There is no B here. Okay, so that is fine. So there is a B here. So put epsilon here. It will become A. So A will be included in this. So in this, there is also epsilon. So epsilon will be included in there because we are eliminating B. So I have to put a B epsilon here. So epsilon will be included in that. And then there is no problem. Okay, so the problem lies here now. A is also becoming a null symbol. So I have to eliminate A also. So again, write all the steps as it is. Okay, so now in this, what you do? A tends to epsilon. So now approach the A. Okay, so now here you can put epsilon first time here, so it will become SA, and second time you put epsilon in this one and now it will become AS. Now you put epsilon in both the one, it will become a single S. Okay, so that I think we have discussed this kind of a step extensively. So if you do not know how I done this step, you can refer to the previous lecture that we have done. Okay, so now in this one there is no a, so there is no problem. So we have got rid of all the epsilon productions in that. Okay, so after getting rid of epsilon production, the resulting thing is this one. Okay, so now the step three is to get rid of the unit productions. Okay, so step three is eliminate unit productions. So keep in mind, do not eliminate first unit productions and then epsilon production. It can differ your answer, but mostly it will be same, but still always try to do null production first and then follow your unit productions. Okay, so now see your unit productions in this one. If I underline this, is this one, and this is also your unit productions. Okay, so this is also your unit productions. Okay, so now what do you do? I have to get to eliminate this S here. So what exactly is S is tending to? S is tending to this ASA, all the things that it is tending. So ASA, AB, and then A, and then there is a A, and then there is a AS, and then there is S. So S is obtained here, you can stop here. So if there is some kind of a loop, you can just stop there. Okay, so now if you want to eliminate this S, you put all the things that is there in place of S. So S is ASA. So anyway, it will become the same thing that is already there. So SA, AS, do not include this S because it will again produce the same thing. That is why I'm not including S here. Okay, in the similar way, so here the unit production is this one. So S tends to again S. So whenever this occurs, so just stop. There is nothing will be included in that. You can directly eliminate this this particular unit production directly. So the resulting result will be again similar. Okay, so that is why I see no point of adding this S naught, because always that this both the steps will be similar. Okay, so there is a little bit of a thing that in parsing that you will understand, that when we are building parsing tree, that is why we include this S naught. Okay, so don't skip this step. This is one of the most important step. Okay, so now in this one there is also another S here. So how can in place of s you know you what can you put. So all the things here in place of s you can put if you want to eliminate this one. And b is also unit production. So see, b is also unit production. So again, see, b is tending to directly a terminal, so you can eliminate this b, and you can write in place of b you can write a single b here. So that is your terminal. And in place of s you can write a s a, same thing, a s a, a b, then a, then s a, and then yes. Okay, so I think now that b is tending towards b. Okay, so you do not eliminate this production, only you have to eliminate unit production. Keep in mind, this is not a unit production. Unit production is that it one non terminal is driving another non terminal. If one terminal is defining a single terminal, that is not a unit production. Keep that in mind, because it is deriving a useful symbol. So you do not consider this one as a unit production. But if a variable is deriving another variable, that is your unit production. Okay, so that is your unit production. Do not consider this one as unit production. So I do not want to eliminate this production. I only want to eliminate this one, and as well as this one. Okay, so in the step three, I got, I think I have eliminated all of this. Okay. Okay, so if you're seeing, now step four is simple substitution. Okay, step four is simple substitution. Now the substitution can easily be done if you how to do a substitution. Keep in mind, the Chomsky normal form or CNF can be written that if I want either, you can write it in any other way. So I'm just writing it S. It can be two capital letters or a single terminal. Okay, so it can be written like this. Okay, so here there are three letters, so keep in mind, underline this one. I can merge these two letters to combine one letter. So it should also, it in this particular case, I want here two capital letters or one letter. So I can put here a capital letter also. In this one, this is fine. So this is correct. There is no problem. This is also fine. This is also fine. So either two capital letters or one small letter, that is fine. Okay, so these are fine. Only their problem is there. Now in this one, this problem is same. This is fine. This is fine. This is fine. Okay, this is fine. The problem here is also same. This is fine. This is fine. This is fine. Okay, so there will be only two or three substitution that can be done. So I can write, so S naught. Now in place of AS, SA, you can write, I use this terminology, CAS. Okay, so it means that in place of AS, I've written one single terminal, that is CAS, and again it is followed by a A. Now this CAS is tending towards a 2AS. Okay, so this is also fine. Now this is now two terminal, non-terminals, that is fine. Now in place of this A, I can put another non-terminal symbol, that is C, in the foot of it, it's A. So you can also write it like this. And this C is denoting CA is tending to a single A. Okay, in place, now it will become CAB. Other things are fine. Okay, in the similar way, S tends to, again, this is the AS. So you can write CAS and then A here. And then there is in place of A, you can write this one. And then I think all the things are same. In the similar way, A tends to B. So there is nothing wrong in B. And AS in place of AS, you can write CAS and then followed by a A. And then in place of a small a, you can write a CA and then B and then SA, AS and a small a. Okay. So I think if you're seeing, there are two capital letters, yeah, that is fine. Here there are two capital letters, that is fine. A single letter, that is single small letter, that is also fine, because I want this form or this form. Two capital letters, that is fine. Two capital letters, that is fine. In the same way, two capital letters, that is fine. Two capital letter, that is fine. Single small letter, that is fine also. Two capital letters. Okay, so this is fine, this is fine. In a similar way, single capital letter, that is fine. Then two single or non-capital letter. So single small letter, that is fine if you're seeing. And two capital letters, that is fine, that is fine, that is also fine. And then Okay, so now if you're seeing this production also, two capital letters, so that is also fine, and a single letter, that is also fine. Okay, so all of the production is now converted into a Chomsky normal form. If you're seeing, it is not very difficult to convert this, but it just requires a little bit of time. Okay, so just wait for a minute. Okay, so if you're seeing, it is very easy to do. Only it will take a little bit of your time. The step four is just substitution. It is one of the easiest step. So you can find one way or another to substitute the variable. Okay.
Sir.
So only, yes.
Sir, in the production, if there is such like two small letters, then what we should do, sir?
If there are two small letters, so just substitute. Suppose I will write CA and CB. And write CA tends to A and CB tends to B. So you can do this one. Okay. So in place of this will also becomes non-terminal. Okay. So substitution is what you find it suitable, you can put it. So there is no particular rule attached to it, but it will be very feasible that if you identify the common variable. Okay. So if you are seeing the common variable in this one is repeating ES, ES, ES. So I have put this one. So that will result in less productions, but there is no compulsion that you always include less production. It can be more, it can be less. It depends upon your choice, okay? So the resulting will be in CNF after performing the unit production step and null production step, okay? So I think you have understand this one. So try to do this question. It is also a bit lengthy question, but it's very easy. If you perform first two step, it will be very easy for you, okay? So do it very carefully. Take your time. I think if you take to solve this question, take your time, it will be very beneficial to do if you do this question yourself. Okay, so just try it, and it's also a very easy question. So only step that will take time is elimination of unit production and elimination of unit production as and non production. The only time the original step will not take any amount of time. Okay, so just try it yourself. This is your null and this is your unit production. Okay, so just try. Okay, so how to solve this one again? The time which will take it, it's elimination of this unit and as well as your null production. Okay, so the step one is again, if S is at the right hand side, so just include this production as naught or as dash. It's upon your choice. Okay, so it will be S naught tends to S, and then S will be your ASB, I think. Yeah, S tends to ASB. And then there is a A, so A is your AAS, and then A, and then there is a epsilon. Okay, so if you are doing it, so just keep doing it. You just follow in the last, just match the ending terms. Okay, so now this will be SBS and then A and then BB. Okay, so now the first step is to eliminate a null production. Okay, so step second is to eliminate null or lambda productions. Okay, so null, keep in mind, right? Null. Okay, so now where are the null productions? So it is present in A, so just write all the things as it is, ESB and then SAS and then A. Just do not include the null production, and then include all the things that are there. Okay, so this is BB. So now if you are eliminating A tends to epsilon, so keep a look at it. So if you put A epsilon here, it will become SB. So SB will be included. In this one, if you include epsilon here, it will be AS. So keep in mind. And in this one, there is only so. Okay, so because of this, there is again epsilon production in this one. So take it in the next step. So write all the productions as it is. ESB, SB. And A tends to AAS and A and then AS, and then B tends to SBS, A and BB. So do not include the epsilon production because we are trying to get rid of it. Now put in place of B, put epsilon. So if I put B here, it will become AS. Put B epsilon here, it will become S. Okay, so it will also we are getting new epsilon unit production in this one. Now take I don't think there is a B here. There is also not a B here. Okay, so that is your production after getting rid of your null productions. Okay, so you have to, now your step three is to get rid of your unit productions. Okay, so now in this one, we just take a look. Now, what are the unit productions? So first is this unit production. So that will always be the same thing. So in place of this, you include ASB, then SB, and then AS. So do not include this S, because whenever you are doing anything, it will also, we have also get, we are again, because if you are, there will be a S and there will be a S. So we, again, in the next step, we will eliminate this production. So that is why do not include this one. And in the next step, again, try to eliminate this one. Okay, so do not include in the starting step here. So now this one will become simply ASB and then SB and AS. And if you see, S tends to S. So S is deriving a S here. So there is no point of doing anything. So in place of S, already all the productions are already there. So no point of including anything else. Okay, so I don't think there is any other unit production. So there is one unit production, that is your A. So I have to see what I have to put in A. So for A, so just write all the expression as it is, AS then A and a single AS. And for B, I have to get rid of this A, so do not include A in place. Now for A, just what, see what can be there. So what exactly A is deriving? A is deriving AAS, a single A, and then AS. Okay, so I do. Okay, so there is no other unit of production that comes in it. So A is also leading to A, so you can stop here. So if there is other unit of production, you go ahead. Okay, so if there is something like this, A tends to B and B is deriving A and some other C, so you go ahead, but there is no unit production in this A. So include all the things that is present here. So include A, AS, then A, and then AS. Okay, so that will be your final production rules after getting rid of your unit productions as well as your null productions. Okay, so now if you're seeing that this is not a very difficult thing to do, but it is just taking a lot of time. Okay, so keep in mind that these steps will take a lot of time, but it is not very difficult. Okay, so now see in this one, what can you eliminate? If you're seeing there are, I want two terminals. Okay, so if I write the production here again as tends to, either it can be two terminal or it can be a single terminal. Okay, so here AS can be summarized, here AS can be summarized, this is two, that is fine, this is two capital, that is also fine, that is also fine, that is also fine. In this one there is a problem. Okay, so you can, if I take these two together, that can also be done, or you can put a capital letter here, then merge these two. So I will do in two steps. Okay, so first step, I will merge this AA together, and this is a single A, this is fine, this is a single A. Okay, so that there is a little bit of a difficulty here. So what can I do? I will perform the first step here, because I want a capital letter here. I will also write a capital letter here. So first step, I will, in place of this A, I will write a CA. Keep in mind in first step. Okay, so now I check another variable. So there is a problem. So I can merge this as P together, but again, there will be a problem. So just let me see what we can do. So this is also not fine. So that is also not correct. That is also not correct. That is the same thing. Okay, so that is the same thing. Okay, so now what we do, we start with the easiest one first. Okay, so now what we will do, this question in one or two steps, so that will be very easy to see. Now you can combine AS as CAS and B, so you have to write CAS tends to AS, and then for SB it is fine, for AS it is also fine. Okay, so for S it is ASB, in place of AS you write CAS, and then B, and then SB, and then AS. Okay, so now for A, what I'll do, in place of A, I put CA, so CA tends to a single A. Now what will happen, CA AS, now it will become 3. Now do not change this A, because this is fine. So if a production rule is already is in CNF, there is no need to change it. So A tends to A, that is fine. And now this is also I do not want. So in place of A, I took a C, A, and S. So that is why I'm taking this one as C, A. So now it will, this is fine, this is also fine, this is fine, this is fine, this is fine. All the things are there. So this is not fine. So keep in mind, we have to do this expression also. Now for B also, there are a little bit of problems here. So if you're seeing SB, for SB, I can convert it to a different one, but if you're seeing BB is also there. So what you do, you put in place of B, you put a capital letter B. So it will be very beneficial, I think. So now it will become three capital letters. So everything, put everything in the same form. Okay, so CBS, and then there are BB. So in place of BB, you can put CB and CB. So that is also fine now. This is also fine now. Now in place of A, I can put a CAS. Okay, so that is the same thing. Now this A is fine, in place of A you can put CAS. Okay, so all the expression I have included, I have already defined here. Okay, so here this is two capital, that is fine, one capital, one small, one small. Okay, so only the problem lies in this one and in this one. Okay, so what you do, you include again, take it to the next step, but I think you can also do it here. But I prefer to make you understand, I will get in the next step. So write all the things as it is. If it is not broken, don't fix it. So that the approach that you have to follow. Okay, so now SB, so substitution can be done in any way. There is no particular rule that is attached to it. Okay, so just let me see if you have any kind of a doubt also. Okay, so now in this particular, just let me complete and I will look at the chat. Okay. So in this particular question, you can combine CA and A to form one thing. So what will you write? C, I will write CAA. Okay, so I will, this is just a terminal, you can do anything. So CAA I have combined, and then there is a S, so there are two terminals here, and then there is a A. Yes, yes.
Sir, for A production, A implies CA, AS. For AS, you can substitute CAS.
Okay, so I think I have already done. Yeah, absolutely. So there is no need to do that. Okay. So there is no need to do that. So because I have already done this here, for AS, the CAS is already defined. So why include no production? Okay. So that is fine. So A, now for AS, I can do CAS. Okay, so that is fine. Now for this is, now I think everything is finished. Okay, CBS, I don't think we have done this thing. Just let me see. BS is not there, so I have to put something for this one. Okay, so AS in place of SC. No, and nothing is there. Okay, so you can put combine this one and include another expression like X. So for that one I will include X, and then for this one I include X. Okay, so now for this one it will become I think all the things are fine there. So CA, for this one I can also combine this as CA, CAS, and then A, and everything is fine now. Okay, so now for this X I have to define X is, now there will be a problem here too. No, there will be not be a problem. Okay, so this X is S and then CB. Okay, so there are two capital letters now. So now repeat all the productions. CAS equal to AS, CA tends to A, CB tends to a B here. Okay, so that is your final answer. Okay, so you can do this in one step. There is no problem in that, but you will find there are some kind of errors in that. Okay, so just let me see if you have any kind of doubt. Okay, I think Adarsh has given the answer. I think it seems correct because all the things that are given in there are following the same thing. Okay, so it can be done in any way. There is no compulsion that what I have done is that you have to follow it. So whatever you find suitable, but in the end there will be either two capital letters or a single letter. Okay, so in this one, if you're seeing a single letter or two capital letters, everything is arranged accordingly. So you can follow any way, but you have to make sure that you have to follow this, that there should be two capital or a single. Okay, in the similar way, GNF is also a very easy thing to do. Now there is no, if you understand the CNF, CNF is very easy. Now in GNF, there is the same thing, just the expressions are a bit different. Okay, so it is written that it can be of the form it can be either of the form. You can include a terminal. So it can be S, a terminal followed by any non-terminals and a single terminal. Okay, so that is fine. Okay, so if it is in the form Grebach normal form, if a particular expression should be in Grebach normal form, first of all, it should be in first of, I will tell you the algorithm, but it should follow the same thing, that it should either be A followed by any number of non-terminals or a single terminal. Okay, so in the CNF there was like something like this, either it can be two non-terminals or it can be one terminal. Here either a terminal followed by a non-terminal followed by a set of non-terminals. So set of non-terminals, it means it can be any number of A's and or it can be a single A. Okay, so that is the form that you have to do. Now the algorithm is fairly simple. It is just saying that if the grammar is not in CNF, you have to convert it to CNF. This is the new thing, eliminate left recursion from grammar if it is exist. So I will tell you about it. And again, the final is the substitution step. So substitution, you can do it in any other way. Just it satisfies the condition of the grammar. Okay, so if a grammar, there are some questions that you can directly see that if a particular thing, you can easily convert it into a GNF. Okay, so I just show you a simple example that for GNF, there are a little bit that you know, if there is no recursion, that there is no need to eliminate the recursion. I will also tell about recursion, but just take a look at the simple example. I will get into the complex one. So there is a very big example that I have to tell you. In that example, all the steps of the algorithm will be followed. Okay, so mostly it's bits and pieces, but if the left recursion is present in the grammar, that you have to follow all the algorithm. Okay, so for GNF, it is just you can write it can the starting symbol or any symbol. It should be of the form. You can call this as A, and I denote a V. It's a non-terminal, so it means that it can be A, V, and then A. Okay, so A, V means it basically means as tends to A, V. Okay, so this is a little bit of okay. So I think I forget about it. It is a V star. Okay, so it is a V star. A single terminal can be followed by any non-terminals. Okay, so that should be there. Just let me confirm that this is the thing. Yeah, absolutely. A single terminal can be followed by any non-terminals, or a single terminal. It can be epsilon also. So it is a terminal. So terminal, keep in mind, terminals are all small letters. In this, epsilon is also included. Okay. So now, this is the GNF. If you want to see a simple question towards that one. So this is a simple question. So I'll just take a look at this. S tends to A, B, A, S, A, and then A, B, A. Okay. So now, in this question, this is a very simple question of GNF. And if you're seeing that, I have to see that A should be followed by a stream of terminals. A should be followed by a stream of terminals. A, so terminal is followed by a stream of terminal. That is not happening here. And terminal should be followed by a stream of terminal. That is also not happening here. So what you do, you just do a little bit of a modification. You can do this like S tends to, in place of B, you can put a big B. Big B tends to a small B. In place of A, you can put a, okay. So now it will become A followed by a BA. So B will become a big one. And this A will also become a big A, and this S will become a S, and then this A can also become a big A. In the similar way, this A followed by a stream of non-terminals. Okay, so this B can be written as a big B, and this A can be written as a small. Okay, this is the final step, that is your substitution. You can directly also see if there is a possibility that you can do it, but if there is a left recursion exist in that, and then you have to see all the steps. Okay, so I'll tell you an example. So that's a little bit of a big example. Okay, so before doing that, you have to see that how to eliminate. There is also another step in the algorithm, that is the elimination of the left recursion. Okay, so what happens here in the left recursion part? Okay, so elimination of left recursion. Okay, so in this step, why I do not prefer left recursion? If what happens in that, suppose if you see the I have told you this one, A star, I think that expression you know about this. A tends to A, E. Okay, so A small a, or it can also be written like this, A tends to A. So I have told you that you can write it either in this way or in this way, it will derive a star. Okay, so that is fine. But if I go in a little bit of detail, I do not prefer this one. I prefer this one. Okay, so why I prefer this one? If you're seeing, it is exactly what is happening here. So if I write it in the form of program, so it can be a function, and then there is some condition. So terminal represents a condition. Keep in mind, terminal represents a condition. So a is greater than equal to 2, 3, 4. Okay. Now it is again calling the function yourself. Okay, so it is again a recursion. A is calling a function. A is calling A. A is calling itself. This is called recursion. But in between, I have a condition. Okay, but see in this one, what happens in this one? A, now write A. Then now there is again, it is calling A. Now there is a condition. Okay, so you will see that in this third line, it will never reach the third line. It can never reach the third line because the condition will never be passed. Okay, so by the help of the condition, you can stop, but it will not stop. Okay, so that is the problem that I do not want this thing. Okay, so that particular thing is called your left recursion. Okay, so if you're saying the element that in the left hand side is again present at the left hand side at the starting of the production rule. Okay, so this is left and this is also left, then this is called left recursion. This is left, but this is right. Okay, so that is called your right recursion. So I do not prefer left recursion. I will always prefer a right recursion. Okay, so how can you convert this into a right recursion? So there is a simple step that you can convert it. So any expression that is written like this, A, so this you have to see this one. So if there is a left recursion, so I write the left recursion. So the formula to convert to eliminate left recursion is this one. A tends to A alpha, and then there is any other terminal that is present in, alongside. So that is denoted as beta. Okay. So A tends to A alpha. So that is your left recursion. It is denoting left recursion. So what you do, convert this one as A. Now the conversion or the solution for this is given as A tends to, you take this beta A dash. Okay, beta A dash. Just let me see if it's the same formula. Yeah. Beta A dash, and write the beta as it is. Do not change anything. Write the beta as it is. And in the next step, take A dash. Now this A dash will become your alpha A dash. Okay, write the alpha as it is. Okay, so you have to write this in the following steps. Okay, this is the solution. So if you are seeing, the condition now lies here. Okay, so now there is a condition coming, then there is a A dash here. So the left recursion is eliminated by following this one. Okay, so it can also possible that this expression can also be present, that there is a stream of terminals that is placed alongside like this A alpha. Now there is a left recursion. Now it can be possible that there is a beta 1, and then there is a beta 2, and then there is a beta 3. Okay, so in this case, what you do, you just again, the solution will be a similar kind of thing here. So it will be A tends to first take beta 1 A dash, then take beta 2 A dash, then take beta 3 A dash, and then just take beta 1, beta 2, and then beta 3. Okay, so just write the betas as it is. Now take another thing as A dash. Now you have to define A dash. Now A dash will be your alpha A dash, and you have to just write the alpha as it is. Okay, so that is how you get eliminate this step. So this is your second, I think your third step. Okay, so this is your third step. If CFG contain left recursion, you have to eliminate. Okay, so how can you know that a particular grammar is containing a left recursion? So if it is present in the similar way. Okay, so if any variable like S tends to SA, so this is on the left hand side, you can directly say that in this particular production rule, the left recursion or recursion or left recursion exist. So we do not prefer left recursion. We prefer right recursion. Okay, so I think, I will share the link of the test, because the question is lengthy that I have to take all the steps. So it will take time. In the next lecture, I will discuss that question. Okay, just let me stop that recording. If you have any kind of doubt, you can ask me.